This is the Art Marketing Minute with Eric Rhodes, author of the Amazon best-selling book, Make More Money Selling Your Art. In the Marketing Minute, we answer your questions to help your art career. Brought to you by artmarketing.com, the place to go to learn more about marketing. Now, here's your host, Art Magazine publisher, Eric Rhodes.
Thank you, Jim Kipping, and thank you for joining us today. I am here. My goal is to eliminate the idea of the starving artist. So let's get right to today's questions. Now, here's a question from Vicki Haley in Montgomery, Alabama, who asks, what should I do when people unsubscribe from my newsletter? Well, I think the first thing you have to do, Vicki, is you have to ask yourself, why did they unsubscribe? People don't unsubscribe unless they don't find the content valuable. And there's a whole lot of things you can do to make content valuable, which we'll talk about in a minute. Now, you can have a way that you can ask people. If you get a rash of unsubscribes, you could take, in theory, take those emails, write them a little note and say, hey, I noticed you unsubscribed. Can you give me some feedback? I wouldn't do it too many times, wouldn't repeat the same people, but maybe you can find out why they're not reading it. But it always boils down to the same thing. They're not reading it because they're not interested, and they're not interested because it's not interesting. All right. Sorry. You know, the problem is that most artists in their newsletters make their newsletter about them, right? It's the news of Vicki Haley in Montgomery, Alabama. Hey, I've got a new painting out. Hey, I did an art show. Hey, I'm cool. The problem with that, Vicki, is that that's not very interesting to other people. It's only interesting to you, maybe to me. So what do we do about that? Well, the first thing we do is we try to make content that people want. Now, in my Art Marketing in a Box program, I developed a whole bunch of content for people that they could kind of have content to do this on a regular basis. But the bottom line is you want to make it interesting. So what would make it interesting? Well, maybe you teach something about art. Now, may not be teaching art itself unless the people getting your newsletter are students. But otherwise, you know, maybe you have an interesting story about art that you open with each time. And then you introduce other things about the stuff about you, you know, your paintings and the things that you've been doing and the trips that you've been taking. But, you know, as a guy who gets 300 or 400 of those a month, and, you know, think about some collectors probably do, you know, they go around, they sign up for websites, and then, you know, they start realizing, well, I open it, I read it, I don't get anything out of it, or I don't like the work or whatever, and so they go away. Now, if they don't like the work, that's a whole different problem, and that's always about getting better. But look for ways to make it entertaining. Everybody wants to be entertained. Everybody wants to get to the point fast. If it's really, really super, super long and wordy, are they going to read it? You know, do you have really great photos? Do you open with something strong? Make it really good. That'll make a big difference. So ask yourself why and ask them why and then make it better. All right. Now, here's a question from Carrie Moore in Cheyenne, Wyoming, who asks, how important is it to have a painting framed at a plein air competition event? I think, Carrie, I think it's critical. I think it's the standard. Right now, you know, first off, you got to have a way to hang the painting in the show. And usually that means it's in a frame. Now, if you're a painter who paints on these kinds of canvases, which have the big thick square edges and you paint around the edges, you know, kind of a modern look, then maybe you don't need a frame. And some people will like that. But, you know, a frame really is there to make the painting stand out. You know, a beautiful frame makes it kind of enhanced. And that's why we put our things in frames, because they make them better. And, you know, the goal is you want to stand out. You want your painting to look great. And now I believe investing in great frames really makes a difference. You know, we have a tendency to go cheap on our frames. And sometimes you can find inexpensive frames that are not cheap looking, and that's okay. But if you're going into Walmart and getting a bunch of frames and just trying to put them in frames, they're not going to look right typically. No, nothing against Walmart or Michaels. But the idea is you want a really good high quality frame. You want something that's going to really make the painting stand out. And then you also need to kind of understand what are the trends of the market you're going into. Like if you're going into a market that's very traditional, then gold frames are probably more appropriate than dark frames. But dark frames tend to do really well in markets that tend to lean a little bit contemporary. And, you know, people will put paintings up that are not contemporary, but if the frames are contemporary, it makes it feel better. Anyway, so that's my
my feeling about frames. I think frames are really critically important.
Well, this has been the Art Marketing Minute with me, Eric Rhodes. My goal in life is to eliminate the idea of the starving artist and to help your dreams actually come true. So if you want to submit questions, simply email eric@artmarketing.com. And to learn more about marketing ideas, you can visit artmarketing.com. Thanks for listening.